it is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Faith,
fragrance, and the fear of God, let us pray for the Lord. Savior's most pure and immaculate temple, the very precious bridal chamber and virgin, who is the sacred treasure of the glory of God, on this day is introduced into the house of the Lord, and with herself she brings a grace in the divine Spirit. She is extolled by the angels of God.
According to the same spirit.
angel singing today. On this day of our 40 consecutive liturgies, I rejoice because sometimes when I share that we're doing this, other communities say, oh, nobody will come. So I see the church is filled with people and perhaps from afar the people viewing. But nonetheless, what better way if we're able than to start the day with prayer and thanksgiving and the divine food of the Eucharist, and then to go in peace and to share that love. Speaking of which, St. Paul, in the epistle that Eleftherios read so beautifully, talked about a special grace that everybody has, and it comes to us through the Holy Spirit. As a point of reminder, St. Paul said that each of us possesses the Spirit of God within our soul, within our
Thank you.
pain and suffering, and for a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of God.
Let's see.
again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts you presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, who loves mankind, having accepted them at his holy and celestial and mystical altar, as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may return, send down upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Veni, pace,
et omnes
patissimus. Quid est in omnes.
Sic in eo.
et a voluntatis suscegatis pro salvece, with fear of God, with faith, and with love, draw near. Save your people and bless your inheritance.
We have seen the true light, we have received the heavenly spirit, we have bowed us to faith, worshipping the only by the Trinity, for the Trinity of
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, O Master.
the protection of the unbodied powers of heaven, the supplication of the glorious prophet, Corona John the Baptist, of the holy glorious and praiseworthy apostles, of the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs, of our righteous and God-bearing fathers, of our fallen holy saints, the doctors, of our Archbishop, Constable, the celebrated, of the holy righteous ancestors, God's love and honor, the great be the one and more creation, the Neo-Caesarea, the Anadis, the Maximus, the Maximus, the Open Righteous, of the Lord, the Queen, the Queen, the Queen, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, who is good and loves mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us. Thank you again for your beautiful stewardship of offering your time and your prayers and your chanting together this morning and serving the altar. And Sarah was here very early helping set up the chapel as well, giving her credit. And likewise for those who tuned in. Remember, St. Gregory, the Wonderworker, has a nickname. I didn't share that in my sermon. But he was called the second Moses. Can you guess why? Because the first Moses was what? Addressing the plagues. And when the plague came in the area where the Gregory was serving, he rid the plague of extreme thirst, and the people was reminded that God was present with his chosen people, and that's why he was such a good leader and steward and shepherd of God's people, because he loved them and he was protecting them. And that in turn is our calling today, to go love the people and to protect them and also